The Modi government had banned 59 Chinese apps last month, and this week they've banned 47 more Chinese apps. A total of about 106 apps now stand banned in this country. The Congress party has mocked the Modi government, though, over reports that the Chinese gaming app PUBG is also under the scanner to be blocked. Congress MP Abhishek Manu Singhvi has used the app ban issue to take a pot shot at the Prime Minister, saying that the Prime Minister wanted to ban PUBG, but then realized that if youth of India do not have distractions of the fantasy world, they will raise real issues like jobs, and that will create a problem for the BJP government. Well, the BJP has hit back at the Congress party, because Abhishek Manu Singhvi is a senior, well-respected leader of the party, and said that the Congress has a shallow view about national security, and the comments of a senior leader like Abhishek Manu Singhvi only reflect that. I'm joined now for a very quick face-off by Gopal Krishna Agarwal of the BJP, Radhika Khera, spokesperson of the Congress, and Jiten Jain, who's an independent cybersecurity expert. Radhika, I'd like to come to you first, because the BJP says the Congress has betrayed its lack of understanding of national security. My question to you is a very simple one, ma'am. Abhishek Manu Singhvi says, you know, he takes a pot shot at the government on what is a legitimate issue, which is employment and things like that. But was it inappropriate to use this as the subject matter? Because the app ban issue is a national security issue. China is watching. Lack of unity between political parties is something that China will always try and manipulate. And when you're talking about youth, this government has already banned apps like TikTok. So why make fun of issues like PUBG to make a larger point?
You know, while we welcome the move of the government to ban apps which threaten our national security and which are stealing away our data, we also urge, at the same time, we urge the government to even ban such companies. They have got companies like Dongfang, which is active in many countries of the world, and they have special relationships with Pakistan. They've been for the Nandipur power project. Now, that company has entered Jammu and Kashmir. Hmm. The data of a state like Jammu Kashmir, we know what the situation is in the country where Jammu and Kashmir is
but
concerned.
But Radhika, wouldn't you, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I'm saying, wouldn't you concede that this has to be a phased process? It can't all happen in one go?
You know, at a time when our country is, the things that we are facing, we have the Chinese killing our soldiers. We have the Chinese constantly promising something and not taking, you know, not living up to their promises. They are not backing up. Satellite images show us something. Experts tell us something else. And the Prime Minister tells the nation something else. The fact is that the government is not seriously doing anything stop these things. Banning apps, we welcome it. But what are you actually doing? You have let companies like Dongfang enter and take away our data. We are readily giving our data to them. Isn't it true that Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, when he was Chief Minister of Gujarat, was going to start Mandarin as a compulsory language in Gujarat?
So the allegation has actually escalated. It's not just PUBG. Gopal Krishna Agarwal, the allegation, and I'll bring Jiten in also for an independent view. Gopal, the view from the Congress now has escalated. It's not just a side joke about PUBG. But this is saying that the government is actively allowing Chinese apps to mine Indian data and not banning them fast enough.
No, this is not the thing. Actually, Congress is trivializing the whole issue. They are forgetting that they had sent out reports from Rajiv Gandhi Foundation that RCEP should be implemented. It's a good agreement with China. It is Prime Minister Narendra Modi. That too in November 2019, that we decided much before this Galwan crisis or COVID crisis that we have to disengage from China's economy because it is hurting our economy, and the Congress was just selling those whole economy. That was the reason.
The Congress's point is that it's not happening fast enough in the current situation.
No,
that's what they're saying.
Fast enough in 10 years, they have not done anything. In November 2019, we have come out of RCEP. We also found that the FTA was benefiting China. We stopped that much. We started reworking on FTA.
Okay,
even in the
okay.
budget, as early as budget, we have increased import duty on 56 items in 8 categories, 8 segments. So the China was getting hurt because of the economic
Okay,
steps being taken
Gopal, you
by the
made your point.
government.
You're
And
saying
now,
that there's no
no, just
question.
10 more seconds.
Yeah.
This 106 apps have also been banned. HDFC China Bank's investment into HDFC
Can I
was
please ask a
stopped.
question?
Then the general financial rules were brought that any investment from China or
No,
FDI will have to first
I
take.
want
So so many steps
Radhika,
they are
Radhika,
just
Radhika, you know,
ignoring
there
because
has to
they
be a
either
process.
no,
I'm
they
sure
do
you
not
have
know,
to
Congress do
I'm
not
sure you would
know the
agree that there will have to
economics
be a
or they
process.
play into
I
the hands of
completely
the
agree. Gopal,
Chinese.
Gopal, hold your peace. One second. Let me ask the question. Radhika, there has to be a process. Ultimately, you know, you've got the government banning 59 apps. They've taken action against a huge app like TikTok, which is even bigger than PUBG, some would say. And now they've
And
banned
general
47
financial
more
rules
apps.
have been brought
What
such
is
a
the problem with that?
huge
They,
change in
it
the
looks like the
law.
government wants to ban more and more Chinese apps. Isn't that a good thing and should be
No, it
supported?
is not only
Like
app, it
I
is
said,
all
no, I know.
the
For the
different.
purpose of this debate, we're talking about the apps. Yes, Radhika. Then I'll bring Jitin in.
See, like I said in the beginning, we welcome the decision of the government to ban the apps. But at the same time, just because you have to look at business relationships, you cannot keep aside the nation's national security at bay. Why is a Chinese company allowed to enter a sensitive state like Jammu and Kashmir through the back door for sensitive work? It becomes a matter of concern. When the government is banning apps on one end and allowing a company which is run by the Chinese government to enter and take away data, and we are
But
willingly
Radhika,
giving them our data
you've
for
taken that
nothing,
one example.
gladly.
What makes you think that company might not be banned in
Want
the
to
next
say one
list?
thing.
Is my question.
No,
Are
the
you is the
government
Congress
is reworking on
nitpicking just to make a point? Is my question
every
when the government
contract
is anyway
with
banning
China.
these apps?
The question is, why was a company called Dongfang, which the world knows, it's
No,
world
now
famous for its
you said
relationship with
only the
Pakistan,
app.
why
Now they
was
are
it allowed
coming to the
to
other issues.
state and
Okay.
government state? China
So
has been
why
attacking us
if
continuously. Pakistan has been
Dongfang,
unpublished
if
it
the
forever.
issue is
Why
contract
was
to the
Dongfang allowed
Chinese?
to enter Jammu and Kashmir? Why was a company like that given
So you're
access
saying
to the
that,
data
okay,
of
I
Pakistan of
don't
Jammu and Kashmir?
know. Radhika makes a fair point. She says that it can't just be about apps, it needs to be about everything else, though. But here on India Today, we've covered the many other different actions that have also been taken. Gopal, I
Many
accept what you're
things I
saying
have told, so many
because there are
issues
many things. There are many things, there are many
initiatives.
actions that have been taken, but there's a big elephant in the room as far as Huawei is concerned as well, where actions are yet to be taken. There are large Chinese investments in this country where action has not been taken. While I concede that things have to happen in phases, assessments have to be made before bans can be put in place. Jiten, is this action of banning apps? Let's try and restrict it to apps for the moment, Jiten. You know, is this an appropriate place for politics and finger pointing between parties? Or does there need to be a unified voice as far as, you know, bringing the axe down on these Chinese? This Chinese sort of digital hostility is concerned.
You know, Shiv, you know, it appears that, you know, we are fighting a war within. The reality is that our polity today is infested with idiots who are trying to impress public with pertinacious jargons. I mean, it is very sad to see a statement, such loose statement coming from a scholarly person like Abhishek Manu Singhvi. I think, you know, people
It's
who do
surprising,
law,
yeah.
they read the books of his father, L.M. Singhvi, and aaj unke bete se aisa itna, I mean, every national security issue, every serious policy debate is being trivialized for evening prime times and Twitter wars. I mean, what have you become? I saw, and this is happening across political spectrum. You know, there are people in Congress, you know, who are earlier making fun of 59 app ban, ki ye kya kar rahe hain, go to war. App ban is nothing. Now they are welcoming it. There are people like Rajiv Pratap Rudi in BJP who are trivializing the app ban and saying that aaj app ban kar rahe hain, kal aap tire company ko ban kar denge, tomorrow you will ban Chinese on roads. I think we have, it is a joke we are, you know, creating on our own people. I think it's high time we should learn a lesson that every serious national security issue must be spoken in one unified voice. There
Okay.
should be absolutely no trivialization of issue, and if somebody has done it, they should withdraw the comment and apologize.
Radhika,
And
it's
it's
a
across political
trivialization.
spectrum.
It is a
It is not about BJP or
trivialization.
Congress.
It is a trivialization. And you've heard what Jiten has said. He has said there are problems both within the Congress and the BJP. He's taken the example of Rajiv Pratap Rudi. But the Congress is a lot to blame here. First, you say 59 apps, no, go to war. Now you're welcoming it. Then you're trivializing the issue. There is a grave problem with how the Congress is approaching an issue of national security.
You know, Shiv, from day one, we welcome any solid step that the government takes when in issues concerning our national security. But unfortunately, we have the Prime Minister lying to the nation. We have the Prime Minister lying टू द लीडर्स ऑफ ऑपोजिशन व्हेन ही मीट्स देम इन अ मीटिंग एंड सेज कोई हमारी टेरिटरी में तो आया ही नहीं है. जब कोई आया ही नहीं है देन व्हाट इज द नीड ऑफ बैनिंग. सो दे आर ओनली कॉन्ट्रडिक्टिंग देमसेल्व्स. नाउ व्हेन एंड दे विल कम अप विद आइडियाज लाइक यू नो वी शुड बैन चाइनीज फूड, दैट इज व्हाट देयर मिनिस्टर्स कम अप विद, बैनिंग चाइनीज फूड. We are open to whatever.
See, you're contradicting yourself even as you speak, Radhika. You know, you're saying you welcome it, but the spirit of welcoming those actions is not there. I mean, this is what I mean. It's confused. It's exactly what Jiten was talking about as well.
The whole Congress is confused on every issue.
You have to take solid
action.
Because
underhand they want to support China, and for Indian public they want to say that we are against China.
Who allowed them to come into Jammu and Kashmir? The whole world knows. The World Bank has said that
I have 30 more seconds. Okay. I just think
the whole world knows that yet that company was allowed to enter. Yet Modi ji goes on with the jhula diplomacy. Everybody knows China has backstabbed us again and again.
As a diplomacy, you don't just say that you do not welcome the head of the country. You don't welcome the head of the
I'm completely out of time, but I think I have to second what Jiten Jain has said in this, and I apologize that I have to curtail this debate because we're out of time. I would have liked to ask more questions, but I promise I will continue this tomorrow and later this week as well. The point is that this is an issue. 20 seconds to you, Jiten. 20 seconds only, my friend.
Shiv, it has been happening across political formations. Who allowed Huawei, Xiaomi to set up, you know, SEZ plants here? You see, you have allowed Chinese construction companies to come in, Chinese companies to come in, power plants in India. So do not talk about BJP or Congress, Radhika. This has happened across political governments in the last 20 years.
Yeah,
Let us now at least wake up and stand in
no
one
time
voice.
For finger pointing.
Let us figure out if there are Chinese, you know, investments or red flags which have been missed.
Only 10 seconds to you, Gopal. 10 seconds. 10 seconds. I'm already in trouble.
Have not
we have been disengaging with China on every issue.
Okay.
And
okay.
China is feeling the pinch of the this. We have disengaged through the industries ban, product ban.
Completely out of time. We want to see more of this, and we want to see a unified voice as this is concerned.
Whatever they are doing, let's
I think Jiten Jain should have the last word. The point is there needs to be a solid, unified voice. No room for tutu meme when we lead, you know, especially with the history that political parties in the country have, and especially in dealing with China. Thank you very much, Radhika, Gopal and Jiten, for joining me here. Apologies again for this short debate. I promise we will take it up again.